Welcome to the MSME Radio Network. The broadcast shows are for informational and entertainment purposes only. They are not designed to provide listeners with specific personal, medical, or counseling advice. Individuals with a medical issue should always consult their healthcare provider. MSME is not responsible for content of individual shows. The views expressed by show hosts or their guests are their own. Enjoy the show.
Hello, everybody. It has been a while, and I apologize to you guys for that. Let me first start by saying, of course, hopefully you guys remember who I am. My name is Anisha. Thank you so much for tuning in with me this new year. Yay. Happy 2018 to everybody. Thanks so much for tuning in this week on MSME Radio. My show is MS Journey. First, let me give you guys an update on my journey with Ocrevus. Everything is going well. It's been interesting, to say the least. everything's good. It's going well. Giving my body that chance to rest and take good care of myself and all those things that the doctor wants me to do. I've been doing all of those things. So everything's going well. There has been a little bit of odd things happening, which is kind of why I'm doing the topic that I am doing today, which is cold weather and MS and chronic illnesses. So that is going to be what we are going to talk about today. But first, from a master resilience point, which you guys know I am, with it being the new year, I want to kind of flash back to 2017. Picture it. I had talked to you guys about hunting the good stuff. I know we're a few days into the new year. Now would be a great time to start hunting the good stuff. If you guys don't remember what that is, at the end of every day, write down something good that happened to you during the day. It can be one thing, it can be two things, it could be three things. It doesn't matter how many ever good things. It could be just one. That's fine. Just something good that happened to you during the day. If you want to put the date, that's fine too. Then you're going to fold that up and place that into a jar, and you're going to do this every day of this year. So at the end of the year, once 2019 hits, wow, look at that, you're going to go back and empty that jar and take a look and reread everything that you have in there, and that way you can start your new year off on a positive note and just looking at those good things that happened to you during 2018. So that is what hunting the good stuff is about. All right, that's a good thing. We all need more good stuff than some of the stuff that we see going on nowadays, right? So don't forget, you guys, if you have the time, just remember it at night really quick, hunt the good stuff. My topic for today, a lot of people talk so much about heat intolerance with MS, okay? And don't get me wrong, I know it's there. I know you guys are like, oh, you know, when it's hot, I'm miserable. I have more symptoms. Things are just awry. There's a lot of people too with MS and other chronic illnesses, because Lord knows we are not going to leave other stuff out, okay? We're just not. Cold weather can have just as much of an effect on people with chronic illnesses like MS, injuries to joints, bones, anything of that nature. Cold weather can have an impact. Of course, I will be focusing a little bit more on MS because I've had so many people message me, inbox me, hey, you know, what's going on? I don't get this, because usually I just, you know, hear people talk about heat. Guess what? The cold does indeed affect us too. Now, one of the major things that I always like to talk to people about, because it's one of the things that my doctors talked to me about a lot as well, and that I just keep stored in my mind. The fact that I have such a huge cervical neck, you know, lesion, that thing is gaping. When I go outside in the winter, one of the first things that I make sure I do is I cover my neck. Okay, so if you think about what you do in the summer with the cooling vest and, you know, the neck wraps and all of those things to keep you cool, you're gonna wanna do the exact opposite in the winter, okay? Because all you're doing is just switching it up. You're going from the summer being hot to the winter being cold. You wanna be able to add a little more heat because that area gets cold when you go outside, and guess what? Those symptoms will start to flare. They'll get aggravated just as much as it is for someone who has heat intolerance. With MS in the cold, you can have your symptoms kind of show their head whenever it's cold. I remember going through this program, which is an absolutely amazing program, and I love the doctor who, you know, I went through the program with. And I remember we were all discussing one day about, you know, weather and things like that, and someone said that, you know, the weather doesn't affect, you know, conditions. And I'm like, oh, whoa, hey, I can be sold on many things, but that is not one of them. 'Cause again, I remember, you know, growing up and, you know, my mom or, you know, some of the older people that we were around, ooh, it's gonna rain, child, 'cause my knee is hurting or my eye is twitching. And honey, let me tell you something. I never thought I'd see those days, but I'm definitely living in those now. When there's, you know, inclement weather moving in, if it's that, you know, it's a temperature degree change for me, about 10 degrees. If it's, you know, a couple days it's been kind of warm and then all of a sudden it's going to drop cold, I'm absolutely miserable. Okay. I'm miserable. I don't let it, you know, stop me. I don't let it be my driving force that, you know, hey, I can't do anything. I can't just shut down. I do try to continue to function, but all of those things that I need to take, you know, precautions that I need to do, case in point, cold weather, boom, I need to put a scarf around my neck. I need to make sure that, you know, I stay warm. I put gloves on my hands, because again, we often deal with tingling, you know, numbness, things of that nature. Socks, you know, I don't step out in some flip-flops like I'm getting ready to go and hit an icy pond and catch some fish or something. Come on now. We all know better than that when it's cold and it's wintry weather. Because, you know, frostbite is no joke. And that's honestly something that, you know, MSers should definitely think about, or people that even have nerve damage alone. It does not just have to be MS. Things that happen, you know, because of frostbite. When you can't feel your fingers, you know, because of nerve damage or even your toes, it does not take long at all for frostbite to take place. Okay. It doesn't, and it's not a good thing to have. People lose fingers, people lose toes, people lose arms, you know, all kinds of things due to frostbite. So just make sure you're mindful and cognizant, you know, of the weather, and also too that you can't feel the way other people can feel because you do have MS, okay? You do have that nerve damage, and those signals just are not kind of moving the way that they should, okay? So make sure that you're, you know, paying attention to the weather, and that you know, okay, tomorrow it's going to be such and such, you know, the temperature is going to be this degree, and if you need to layer your clothing and maybe take off because it's going to warm up, you know, or whatever the case may be, please make sure that you do that and that you're mindful of it. One thing that I always do as well is I'll make sure that I have like an extra sweatshirt or a hoodie or, you know, something like that in my car, because I'm kind of cold natured anyway with not having much body fat. So I just make sure to stay warm, because your symptoms definitely can start to aggravate and you will notice them big time. Funny thing, I kind of posted on my Facebook about it, because I haven't had too many, you know, things per se isolated, definite MS, you know, since starting Ocrevus. But with a change in weather that was coming, my nose started twitching. My nose was twitching all day long. And I was like, oh my gosh, I feel like this lady on Bewitched. Can I, like, you know, cross my arms and nod my head and end up in Hawaii, please? I'll take Hawaii for 500, please, Alex. That really would have been great, because I knew that, you know, this weather was coming and it wasn't going to be good. And, you know, a little bit of pain in joints and things of that nature. But again, that just definitely told me, guess what? Your body is telling you, girl, as much as you want to still continue to say you're 21 with shipping and handling, you are not that. You are definitely got some years on you. Pay attention. So that is exactly what I did. And it's very, very important for people, you know, MS, lupus, people that have had joint replacements, people with arthritis. There's just so many things, people with diabetes, because they have a lot of nerve damage that, you know, we live with as well. It's no joke. It is absolutely no joke. So definitely too, I want to say, if you don't have to be out in the elements, please don't. Okay. If it's just not necessary that you have to be out there, please do not. But if you do, please make sure that you're dressed appropriately for what the temperature is. And keep in mind where you got those little dead areas that you can't feel. Okay. Cause I definitely don't want to hear that, you know, someone has frostbite or, you know, anything like that, and they weren't aware of it. So now, again, a lot of people, it's so important, because I think with awareness of multiple sclerosis, many people are like, oh yeah, so you guys can't be in the heat. Honey, I love the heat. Okay. The heat is great. It does not bother me at all. And well, okay. So wait a minute. Let me back up just a second. The incident that I had in July, when the ambulance found me and I had been in the heat a little bit too long and had some issues with my heart. Yeah, that wasn't good. But stress was a little bit a factor in that as well. So the heat did get to me then, but I just really didn't realize that I was hot. So boy, I was heated. I was more angry than anything. But anyway, just please keep that in mind. And y'all know me by now. I make jokes about this stuff, because either I'm going to laugh about it or I'm going to cry about it. And to me, it's more important to just laugh, because if you cry, you're going to spend the rest of your life crying. And Lord knows we all still have a lot of life left to live, because if we didn't, we wouldn't have been on the wake up list for this morning. Okay. We were blessed by the good Lord to be able to open our eyes, to even be able to hear me talking to you right now. So that in itself is a blessing. And whatever ways that, you know, I can help to, you know, bring awareness even about these things with the temperature and MS, because, you know, last year, considerably for many places, it was pretty much a mild winter. Like, it is some serious stuff going on here now. And, you know, global warming, let me stop right there. I'm not even going to go there, because, you know, it just is what it is. You know, there's changes, and we have to make sure that we adapt to them. By all means, for anybody, if, you know, you have a friend or a loved one and you haven't seen them in a while, and, you know, they live close to you, or you haven't talked to them, you haven't heard from them, pick up the telephone, see how they're doing, see what's going on, stop by the house, see how they're faring, see if they're fair to Midland. Okay. Let's just spend more time, you know, helping out each other, because Lord knows that's what we're all placed on this earth to do. Okay. So keep that in mind. Elderly people that live near you, stop by and check on them, especially with this weather, how it's so cold in so many places. Okay. People that are on the, what they call it at the church, the sick and shut in list. Okay. Stop by and check on them. See how they're doing. Give them a phone call. Okay. Also, as you guys know too, it is flu season. So I will say that if you are sick, keep your butt inside your house, okay? Don't, you know, try your best not to go out, you know, spreading that to other people, because there's, you know, innocent folks that are out there taking care of their business that they need to get done. And they could be like me and many other people who have things like MS and have a compromised immune system, and just literally being somewhere that you have been, end up catching the flu that might take you 5 days to get over, as someone who is seemingly healthy. For us, it can be deadly, okay? So please make sure to keep that in mind. If you're sick, do your best to stay home. Do your best to, you know, stay in your bubble. It's just a whole, you know, courteous thing. Like, I get it. You know, most pharmacies nowadays, they have drive-throughs. So try to hit those if you're sick. You know, just think about everyone else, because the flu is not only rough for people that have, you know, chronic illnesses. It's also very rough on the elderly, and it's also very rough on babies as well. Okay, so we just want to think about fellow man and, you know, what it is that we're doing. Boy, I sound like I'm preaching to y'all today, okay? Can I get a witness? Woo. No, I'm sorry. I don't mean to sound preachy, but, you know, it's just really important to, you know, talk about these things, because, you know, sometimes we forget. We're so busy going, you know, day to day, and we're just not thinking, and, you know, something happens, and we're just busy, and we just don't stop and think, you know, of, you know, those things, or, you know, those precautions that, you know, we, you know, may need to take, you know. And everybody, please remember, the best key that you need to prevent illnesses or to prevent from spreading is hand washing. That's going to be a number one for anybody, okay? Just make sure you're washing your hands, and you're washing them very good. That's going to be your number one defense against spreading germs and stuff like that. So just make sure to do that. Me, it's so funny. I'm a big fan of Bath and Body Works and all of their antibacterial products, and I think it's more because they smell so good. I'm not saying that they work that great. I think the Purell line probably works a lot better, but they smell really good. So just keep that in mind with being sick, and I'm thinking about others at the same time. And again, watch the weather. You know, I'm not saying, you know, sit in front of your TV and watch everything else that's going on, because as y'all know, the news and things like that can just honestly stress you out. I'm not saying that you have to do that. You can even get online and check out the weather and watch and see what's going on. Possibly get mobile alerts to where you live to see what's going on with the weather. If you're a person who does not watch the news, I completely can understand that. I can respect that 100%. But, you know, just make sure that you're getting those that information. Also, through the CDC as well, there's ways that you can find out areas that are being highly impacted by the flu, okay? You want to make sure that you always know what's going on in your area with that too, because it looks like right now that type A is going around pretty bad, and that could, you know, really be bad, and it's awful. So want to make sure to try to keep yourselves healthy, you know, as best you can. And if you get it, if you have it, I'm praying for you. You are in my prayers, and I hope that you definitely start to feel better. And sorry about that, because I totally did what I always do, and y'all know what that is. I went squirrel. I always do it. So let me get back to cold weather. Again, y'all, cold weather, it definitely can impact you if you have MS, okay? Think about where your lesions are. Think about, you know, if you've got them there on your brain, you know, it's cold. Your hair is not always going to keep your head, you know, warm, because think about it. Your head is a lot of where heat escapes anyway. So definitely put on a hat. Go find you a stylish hat where you're still looking cute. I've seen many, okay? I'm a big hat person, so it doesn't mean that you won't be, you know, a fashionista if you have a hat on. Anyway, it's more about, you know, being healthy and protecting yourself than it is about being cute. I know I'm not buying that one either. Seriously, just make sure that you, you know, cover everything and keep your feet warm, all that good stuff. And your shoes, again, you guys, make sure that you have that warmth, you know, that you're keeping your feet warm. if you start to have, you know, odd symptoms where, you know, you, those misfires, you know, to the hands, the legs are feeling bricky, you know, things of that nature, you're not getting around well at all, you know, guys, remember, do not drive yourself to the emergency room. What are you going to do? You're going to get someone else to drive you to the emergency room, because you always want to make sure that you are what? Safe. That is our good word, safe. Not just safety for yourself, but safety for others, for people that are on the road, because it is very difficult if you cannot feel your feet going from the gas pedal to the brake. You know, it can be very dangerous. So make sure that you get someone else to take you to the emergency room, or you call 911. All right. That is like a lovely public service announcement, because I feel like a lot of people forget that. And I see, so, you know, a lot of times people say, oh my gosh, go to the emergency room, take yourself there now. You got to think about safety first. Okay. Because it's nothing like, you know, having an accident and then ending up going through everything with courts and police and all that good stuff. That's just a bad situation. You know, call 911. And have them transport you, or, you know, phone a friend, have them take you. Now, there's just, I've seen a lot too, where people have been talking about different things with their insurance, and, you know, they're confused with, you know, what's happening with it, you know, if they're still with an HMO, if it went to a PPO, that sort of thing. Guys, the best thing that you can do is to make sure that you call your insurance provider, okay? Because you can ask me, but at the end of the day, I'm not gonna know, to be honest, okay? Because I'm not an expert at that, okay? But your insurance company will be able to tell you, okay? What it is that, you know, you have, if it's HMO, if it's a PPO, or whatever the case may be, please keep in mind with your deductibles and all those type of things, this is a great time to get that new accordion out for the year, labeled January through December, because we're now in what, 2018, and you're keeping your new records for this year with your appointments and everything in the proper month. That's to include scans, MRIs, the reports from all of that stuff in the new month, you know, January. Then when next month hits, you're going to go with February. You know, you're just going to keep all of that stuff in one neat place and labeled 2018. So that way, in the event that you need anything, it's in one spot, centralized, and you will be able to get to it easily without stressing yourself out. Okay. Because there's nothing like looking for something and you're like, man, I know I saw that thing on my desk. And then you go to your desk and it's not there. So then you kind of hit, well, maybe it was in my purse. And then you go look in your purse and it's not there. And you kind of freak out a little bit because you can't find it, you know? So when it comes to all this medical stuff, make sure that accordion folder is just great. Start right here, 2018, January. Everything for this month goes into January slot, okay? And continue this, okay? Again, from that point of resiliency, this will help you be resilient in living with this disease process, or any disease process for that matter. If you're a person who has to frequent the doctor a lot, this is definitely something that you want to do that can help you thrive with your illness, okay? Is just by being more organized, okay? Also, I don't know what has been going on with me, because you guys know that I am a person that is big on sleep hygiene, just as much as I am, you know, body hygiene, is that much on sleep hygiene. But I think that that's because Alabama won that national championship on Monday. Roll Tide. Yes, that game, y'all, excited me so much that Monday night I could not get to sleep. Tuesday, I got a little sleep Monday night. Tuesday, I was still excited, like, I cannot believe we won, you know, and uber excited. And, you know, me and my fellow Bama family, you know, we're just excited, you know. So Tuesday, again, insomnia, It is just really riding on me, okay? It really is. So I'm gonna make sure to kind of get back to my basics, with sleep hygiene of, putting my phone on sleep mode, things of that nature where I'm not picking it up, looking to see, okay, what has SEC clips put out, or what's the University of Alabama talking about, that type of thing, or what about my friends that don't like Bama? What are they posting? Let's see what's going on here. Think about your sleep hygiene. Now is a good point to get that back in the kind of good, forefront of your mind. Okay. Because again, I did not necessarily make a New Year's resolution this year, but a good resolution for someone who is living with a chronic illness could be to do things better, like sleep hygiene. Okay. I have just been so good at it that I did not expect for that game to be able to throw me off like it did, but it did. So honestly, now, how many ever days into the new year, that is now my resolution is sleep hygiene. I'm going to get that back on track. And please remember, you can make a resolution anytime during the year. It does not have to be, the new year per se in order to do that. But if it is, becoming too much because the holidays are rough on people with chronic illnesses. It's very rough. It takes a lot to recover from, for us. It's almost like when you go on vacation, you get to recover from the vacation that you went on. Okay. So, it's kind of like that for us with the holidays. Okay. So just keep everything in mind and, be mindful of stuff. If it's going on for too long, make sure that you talk to your doctor about it. But sleep hygiene is very important. And again, if it's something that you guys want me to talk about with you all with sleep hygiene, just let me know. Again, you can look me up on Facebook, Anisha Hankins, if you want me to have a show and talk to you guys about sleep hygiene. Again, I definitely will do that. Remember, just as much as there's heat intolerance with MS, there is also cold intolerance. Okay, bundle up, keep your neck warm in case you have lesions there on your neck. Stay warm. Think about those areas where your fingers, your toes, where frostbite can occur, arms. Think about where you have numb areas at. That's very important to do as well. And also remember, it's a new year. We're now in 2018, and part of being resilient and living with chronic illnesses or diseases is to hunt the good stuff. Okay. Again, it could be one good thing that has happened to you, during the day. Write it down, put it in that jar, and I promise you later on, it's going to come in very handy for you. All right. All right, you guys. It's good to be back. Y'all take care. Have a great week, and I love you guys.